Hello everybody, how you doing? I am Shitanshu from Dream Abroad, and in this video I'll give you a short-term prediction of the CRS cutoff score. How the CRS cutoff score is going to vary in the next couple of months, not more than that, just couple of months, based on some logics and some trends, I can predict it. But before I start the video, I want to request all of those people who watch my videos but don't subscribe to the channel, please go on to click the subscribe button so that you don't miss any of the videos. Okay, now I suppose that most of you would have known the results of the Express Entry Draw 117 by now. If you still don't know it, let me tell you that the Express Entry Draw was conducted on 15th May. And this was not an all program draw. This was a program specific draw only for federal skills trade class. The CRS cutoff score was 332. There's a lot of confusion regarding this draw. So please note that this draw was only for federal skills trade class. Let me show you directly the official page of Government of Canada where we get all this information from. So this is the page where you'll see all of the updates. So you can see over here that the number of invitations were 500 and the time of the draw, the tie-breaking rule. But this draw was only for federal skills trade program. I have actually found out for you guys what is the skilled experience. So this is the skilled experience which is required in all of these NOC codes. I won't get into details of federal skilled trade class because this video is about the prediction. So I'll come straight to that point. Okay, now the point to note over here is that the last draw was conducted 14 days before. As per the usual trend, the last draw was conducted 14 days before on May 1st, 2019. That point of time, the CRS score was 450. Now, very important logic over here is that with the regular trends that we follow, if the two consecutive draws are conducted in less than 14 days time frame, the logic says that the draw score, the cutoff score would actually go down. Or if the number of invitations issued actually increases, then also the draw, logically, the cutoff score would go down. So after 1st of May 2019, another draw conducted 15th of May, which means 14 days after that. 14 days are gone. Now generally, the draws are conducted on every Wednesday or sometimes on Mondays. Now this time, the upcoming Monday is a bank holiday in Canada. It is the Victoria Day and it is a bank holiday. So there's a high chance that the next draw would be conducted on 22nd of May if they do it on Wednesday. Maybe 27th if they do it on Monday, or maybe 29th of May if they want to do it on Wednesday again. So forget the 117th draw. If the next draw, which is the 118th draw, is actually conducted on May 22nd, this is going to go high because of the 3 weeks gap. And if it is going to happen on 27th of May or 29th of May, this will go really, really, really high. Now let's check the trends, what has happened in the past. So I've opened few of the previous results here. So this was the previous time the Federal Skill Trades Program draw was conducted. This was the program specific draw, just like the 117th draw. So before that, the score was 441. And after that, it rose to 445. Mind it, there was only 2 week gap here between the alternate draws. So this draw was conducted on September 19th. After that, just 1 week after that, September 24, another draw was conducted. Just 1 week after this one, another draw. So just 14 days gap between these two, but still CRS score actually increased. Now let's take another example. So this was May 30th, draw number 91. So if you check the draw before this, it was May 23rd. This cutoff score was 440. Now, 1 week after this, another draw was conducted, which was May 30th. And 2 weeks after this draw, the next draw was conducted. So 11 CRS points were increased in the cutoff score. And this is the exact scenario which I was talking about. So if the next draw is conducted on 22nd of May, expect the CRS score around 460. or if it is conducted even after that, then expect it something around 465, which will be very difficult for most of the people to achieve. Yes, I know it's a bad news, but whatever it is right now. So this 117 draw has got a lot of bad luck for many people. This is just another example again over here. This was the draw which was conducted on 18th October. 436 was the CRS score at that point of time. After that, this draw was conducted, which was for FSTC and PNP only. Then the next draw comes over on November 8. You see the rise, 458. Oh my god. So 3 weeks probably from this time, and then you see the rise. It's 436 to 458. 21 points have been increased over here. But yes, the relief for all of you guys would be that in the very next draw, it would drop. Definitely it would drop. It won't be that high, like 460 or 465. It would definitely drop, but it will drop until 450, 455, something like this. Not at all below 450. So in a nutshell, my prediction, next draw would be something like 460 to 465. After that, it will drop. It would be between 450 to 455. If you're very lucky, if the draw is actually conducted in less than 14 days, if the number of invitations issued is more than 3,350, in that case, it would go below 450. But yes, apart from those two cases, do not expect the draw to go down below 450 for the next 2-3 draws. It's not going to happen. So yes, probably in the month of July, you can expect it to go down below 450, but not before July. In the month of May and June, it's going to stay way above 450. I don't think there's any chance of the CRS cutoff score going below 450 or even 450 in the next couple of draws. However, this is my prediction. My wish is that it actually goes down so that the Canadian dreams for most of you actually comes true. I really wish that the CRS cutoff score actually drops to 430 so that many of you waiting in that queue actually get the ITA and your Canadian dream actually becomes true. So let's see how it goes. If you agree with my prediction, please click the thumbs up button. And also please comment down below. Let me know what you think your prediction is. According to the logics, according to the trends, what you think is going to happen in the next couple of months.